renowned grime producer, definitely top of the league, I would say. Like,
yeah,
and I don't think many would argue with that. Like, you being top of the league, would you say that's like, how do you feel about that?
You know what? Yeah, I would say I'm top of the league, yeah, but I won't say that I'm the best, you know what I mean? Because I know there's a lot of great other producers doing a lot of stuff that are even like not really in the league with their work rate and that. Like, I'd say I do work hard, you know, and I'm definitely up there with the top dogs in it. So that's what I'll respect myself about.
Yeah, your footprint in the grime scene traces back like 3-4 years back, you know what I mean? But some might just only know you for producing Pow 2011 for Lethal Bizzle, man.
Yeah,
but
yeah, I've done a lot more than when I met Lethal Bizzle. Like, I've worked with people like Skepta, JME, Getz, Badness, loads of people. I've worked with, well, loads of people before I met Bizzle. So for the people that actually don't know now, they know that, like, I've worked with a lot of people. My back catalogue is very strong at the moment.
So for those that don't know, man, just give us a brief history into the musical life of Teddy, aka Silencer, from back in the
day. Yeah, definitely. My name was called Silencer from like school times, like back in the day. Like, from it's even as young as when I used to watch Pokemon and that, you know what I mean? Like, when I used to, it started even from Cypher. Like, I call myself Cypher, like, when I was like year 7, and when I got to like year 8, year 9, I renamed myself like Silencer. So I thought, okay, cool, like, sounds like a good name. I didn't really know the meaning to it at the time. Yeah, then it just got a bit popular with it, and then everyone started calling me Silencer and enjoyed the name. Then I started getting onto radio from like 15, 16, and then when it got to like 17, then I started the producing, and people were telling me to keep going at it, keep going at it, and then I started going more at it, sending my tunes about on MSN. But them times there, I think I weren't on radio, I was on internet radio them times, yeah, so I started like sending out my tunes on MSN, like trading with other people. Then Maximum got hold of my track, but he didn't tell me he liked it, so I kind of like still was at the same level. Then people started calling me saying, yeah, Maximum played your track, and I was like, all right. Went to go listen to it and then realized, okay, cool, maybe it's only one play, you know, like maybe next week he might play my tune. And he played it again, and I thought, all right, let me send him some more stuff. And then it just carried on going, and then more DJs started to hit me up and started requesting my tracks. Then that's when the vocals with different artists started popping up, and then I became very popular.
That feels good, man, for you to, you know, put all your work together and put it together as a compilation and actually retail it, because there ain't many like sort of compilations or bodies of work like this at the moment, man. What made you actually decide to put your work out as a compilation like this?
Because you know what it is, like, I kind of think very different to a lot of producers that do what they do today. It's like a case of like, I kind of look more on the bigger picture. I don't just kind of look on getting played on a one radio show or a two radio show. I kind of look at bigger pictures, and I speak to a lot of distributors and a lot of labels. And when it comes to me releasing music, I kind of think, okay, cool, if I release a track, people will pay more attention to it and would respect my work a lot more and value it. So I was like, okay, let me put together everything that I've done so far as a CV and then put it out there for the people to get now if they're paying attention. And when I'm 5 singles or 5 albums ahead, then they'll be able to go on iTunes and be like, okay, I wonder what Teddy Music's made, and type in Teddy Music and see that there's Grime, a compilation CD, his first compilation CD that he's ever done. So once they see that, then they'll be able to buy it, and they've literally got a back catalogue of everything I've done, like almost so far at the time, you know what I mean? So maybe what I might do is I might do a couple more, or I might do a few more albums, and then once I've done a few more albums, I'll just pick all the bangers out of the albums and then do another compilation CD as the best of. It could be a best of Teddy thing. So that's what I'm kind of trying to do. Like, I'm trying to just market properly and plan certain things at the right time.
Well, you know, those Teddy signature beats have been like, you know what I mean, the sound of the underground for the last, boy, as we've been saying, 3-4 years.
Yeah, I'm proper proud of myself, man. I'm glad that everybody likes my music, you know.
Of course, but like, I see, you know, naturally you changed your name from Silencer to Teddy, and that was like, what, forward thinking with some marketability in mind, right? Was that the reason why?
Yeah, because it was a case where like, I loved the name, yeah. I, to be honest, it still hasn't left me, because a lot of people don't know how to call me Teddy. Mm-hmm. So they say, oh, I don't care about your whole Teddy thing, I'm calling you Silencer. So, you know, like, if that's what they enjoy calling me, then cool, I'll still respond to it, because that's the name that's in the back of my head still. So I'll respect that. But on the more marketable and more approachable by certain people that might be timid to, you know, like, approach me, they'll actually prefer to actually get in contact with me if I was called Teddy than Silencer, because Silencer's like, seriously, there's a lot of people, like, they might not say it, but there's a lot of people that are afraid of a lot of people in the grime scene due to either their name or their personality, how they are. Yeah, and I'm not that kind of guy because I'm a very friendly person. I don't ever give anybody the wrong end of the stick. So if they hear that a producer made a track, what's his name, Teddy Music, oh yeah, yeah, I don't mind contacting Teddy. But if there was someone called Killer or Killer Man Every Day, if there was someone called Killer Man Every Day, like, I'm sure a big man upstairs wouldn't want to come and see Killer Man Every Day. You know what I mean? Like, so, you know, it's just an example, but I know someone wouldn't call themselves Killer Man Every Day, but it's just an example.
So with the marketability in mind and aspirations to take it major and maybe commercial in the future, you know, a lot of the MCs out of the grime scene have been getting signed over the last few years, yeah, and have been turning their back on the grime scene.
Do you know what I plan to do? I plan to make commercial grime. I don't want to leave grime, like, because what it is, a lot of people are using grime as a stepping stone, and then once they've got to where they get, then they leave it, and then they say, I'm too grown up, or you grow out of things, or you ain't gonna do grime forever. No, then you broaden your horizons and you get more creative. You keep it grime, but you move kind of out of the whole, just the straightforward underground dark hardcore music. You bring it out a bit, keep it the same tempo, same sounds, just make it a bit different for the peoples to hear it, and then that will still be your genre. Because the more people that keep leaving the genre and keep doing pop and hip-hop and all that other stuff there, the smaller it gets, and then the harder they have to work because they're not so good at doing what they do. They have to just work hard with what they have, and then people see that as the grime scene, and then they devalue it more because the people that are running it now ain't that sick as the ones that have gone. You understand what I'm saying?
So let me ask you though, man, how do you feel about it's been quite frequent though, there's been quite a few MCs that have been signed to major record labels that have come out of the grime scene and have turned around and said that they're not a grime MC.
Yeah,
and they've, like, kind of denounced the grime title. How do you, as the signature grime producer, feel about that?
I slightly don't respect that, because reason being, like, to be honest, I'm not telling you to come back, you can do what you're doing, but the only reason why I'm not really happy about that, because they say they're not a grime MC, but then you go and jump on that pop tune and you sound like you're freestyling, so where do you really need to be? You know what I mean? Like, you sound like you're on Deja or you're on Rinse FM spitting with everybody. Like, you sound like that. So for you to say that you're not a grime MC, like, you need to chill. You know what I mean? A lot of them need to chill.
Someone that you've worked quite frequently with, Dot Rotten, was one you came out with quite recently, man. He had an interview with a big newspaper and he turned around and said that he's not a grime MC, doesn't make grime music.
Do you know what it is? Maybe he feels that there's not enough money coming from the grime industry. That's why he could be frustrated at the fact that it's not bringing in a lot of funding, or it's not doing a lot for whatever he's doing. He feels that doing whatever he's doing gets him more exposure. That's fine. You can go and do that. I think, like, because he's a cool guy. I know him anyway. We work together all the time. But I don't know. I just feel that I personally, to me, from where I've grown up and I've bought all the tracks off in Bazooka, and that, to me, he's a grime MC. But he's taking it to different areas. He wants to kind of get out there a bit more in different genres. He enjoys different genres more than grime, maybe. You know what I mean? A lot of people enjoy to go and do certain genres, but they still love grime. You know what I mean? And I believe if you can still do that, then I respect that. Because there's times where I think he's come to me saying, yeah, he doesn't really care about grime like that, but then I'll play him a tune and he's spazzing out, he doesn't know what to do. You know what I mean? But end of the day, as long as you like grime and you don't mind doing it, if you hear a good track, then I'm happy with that. And I'm sure you probably would do that if you heard a good track.
We came out at a track called Grime and it's got Dot Rotten on it.
Yeah, definitely.
And it's got Getz on it as well. Like, yeah, recently Getz. He kind of, like, you know, we spoke to him recently and he was talking about, like, the new wave MCs and how some of the new wave MCs really feel like they have to make violent music because the consumers and the fans aren't letting them make, like, more emotional music and music aside from the violence, because otherwise they're going to turn around and say it's moist. But whereas back in the day, Dizzy could have made I Love You, Kano made Girls Love Boys, but now it's not cool to make tracks like that. How do you feel about that?
Who told you it isn't cool to make tracks like that? The fans ain't allowed to decide anything. Once you put out the music, you're the output, so they can't tell you what to make. Like, if they don't want to listen to you for the music you make, then you go elsewhere to listen to the music. If you don't like Teddy, you listen to Rukid. If you don't like Rukid, you listen to Royalty. If you don't like Royalty, you listen to G-Tank. Everyone makes different variety of music. So if that artist there wants to make tunes about girls and kissing them on their neck and the sky is blue and the clouds are purple when I first met you, then let them do that. Like, if you don't like that, then go and listen to someone else that talks that. Like, you shouldn't feel the need to go and do that because the fans don't like that, you know what I mean? So it's like everyone's seeing that because pop's getting so successful, we should go and run to pop. No, you work hard in what you do and it will excel and become a bigger scene and everyone will respect him more, and then that's when more money comes into it and more value comes into it and everybody gets enough exposure, you know? Because I believe that if all them pop people that were grime flew straight back to the grime scene, we would be the biggest genre. Think about it, all of them now, they all started grime. If they all came back to grime and did grime, definitely would be a big genre, you know what I mean? And then definitely the labels will start putting more money into that because that's where they came from and that's where they originated, you know?
Well, with the grime scene being like relatively a fetus in regards to, you know, how long it's been around, it ain't been around for that long.
Exactly.
Like, you know what I mean? We're only now really kind of entering the second wave of a generation of MCs, which everyone's calling the new wave. But like, you know, people are obviously going to compare the new wave to, you know, the first kind of MCs that emerged out of the game. And they're saying like the content of these new wave MCs is quite raw, quite violent. Like, how does Teddy think?
Yeah, I think it's a bit, they're good, like they're enjoyable artists to listen to, but I think it's got a bit, it has got a bit violent and it's a bit different from how the old school MCs used to kind of portray the way they spray. Like, once, like, they would say certain things, they could sound more greasier than a proper violent MC, but in a funny way, you know what I mean? Like, there's ways to control it. If you're just sounding so straightforward, that can actually stop you from getting radio plays and all of that kind of stuff there, because you're not portraying it in the right way. Like, that's why I love working with the old school artists and bringing them back, because that's what I'm trying to do now for my album. I'm trying to bring a lot of like old school artists that don't really care about grammars today to come back onto the gram kind of sound and bring out good music, because I'm still letting them know that there still is good music out there to be made in gram.